the heck? Why are my results on generative AI and Adobe so much worse than everybody else's? Well, there's actually two big reasons, and the first one is really going to surprise you, not using the selection tool properly. One of the most important tools in generating this AI is making the right shape with the selection tool. The problem is you're using it as a selection tool, trying to get perfect selections. It's not how it works. Use it to sketch the outline of what you want to create. Let me demonstrate, and then we'll get to reason number two. And by the way, you need to be inside Adobe Photoshop Beta to be running this. You'll go to Creative Cloud, and on the left-hand side, you'll see Beta Apps. My other video shows you exactly how to set that up. All right, so let's make a selection. Let's just grab the Marquee tool, and I'm going to make a selection around her head here. And I want a hat, right? So I'm going to hit Generative Fill. And in order to prove how important this is, I'm not going to use any other descriptors, just the word hat. So I'm going to type in hat right now. And before I hit generate, because of this shape, I bet you we're going to get something like a beret or something like that. And we're going to let it generate. And boom, look at that. So how did I know we were going to get a beret? Because of the shape of the selection that I made. If you look at this selection, and by the way, it creates a mask. I'm just going to just select that mask quickly. Notice I went very high up on her head, which means it can't go down low like you would get with a beanie. And also it's not up very high, so we can't get something like a top hat. In fact, why don't we dump this selection altogether? I'm going to make a brand new selection, and I'm going to bet that we're going to get a top hat or a party hat. And I'm saying that before I even make this selection. And we're going to start from here, and I'm going to go up high. So I'm going to give this lots of room at the top. So it's going to take all this area to generate the hat. Let's hit generate a fill, hat, hit generate. What did I say? It's going to be something like a party hat, like a top hat, or maybe one of those, you know, New Year's hats. It's going to be tall. And look at that. Did I call it or what? And if you're getting any value out of this video, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. All right, are you starting to get the picture? Okay, so what we want to do now, in order to generate what you really want, number one, the shape is really important. Number two is descriptors. So what you want to avoid is things like remove this object or select where you're telling it to do something because it doesn't work that way. What you want to do is name the object and then give properties of that object, such as the color, the material it's made out of, whether it's old, new, etc. I want to create a pom-pom hat. I don't know what they call them here, but in New Zealand, it's a pom-pom hat. You know, you get the woolen hat with the little pom-pom, the ball on the top. I think they call it that in the UK as well. And even though I've been in the US a long time, I'm from another country, so maybe they call it something different here. Let me know. So watch this. I doubt it's going to get what we want, but let's try it. We're going to type in pom-pom hat. And then we're going to hit generate. Okay, so this violated some of the user guidelines, so maybe a pom-pom hat means something different than what I thought it did. All right, so I'm just going to ditch that, and we're going to create a new selection. So let's create a selection that goes lower, and we even go down where we're going to allow it to go as low as the eyes. And then what we want to do is give it lots of space on the top, but I'm going to make it more rounded. And now we're going to hit generative fill, and we're just going to type in woolen hat. And there we go. Look at that. We've got a pom-pom hat. I've got three different ones. So what if we wanted to change the color of it to blue? Blue woolen hat. And now we get a blue hat. So what you can see here is the object was following the shape of the outline that it was creating. Let's try another example. All right, who doesn't love a guitar amp? Let's put a cat on top. So what we're going to do first of all is we're going to grab our crop tool and we're just going to extend this up a little bit. Give ourselves some space so we can fit this cat in there. That's looking pretty good. And then we're just going to grab the marquee tool, make a quick selection here, and we're just going to fill this just by hitting generative fill and just leave it blank and just hit generate and it'll create a background for us. Perfect. Now, if we want to create a cat, and I want a cat that's standing up. Watch this. I'm going to go down a little bit here into the top of the speaker, and then we're going to go here. It's going to be a pretty big cat. I'm going to bet we've got a cat that's either standing or sitting. And we'll just type in cat. We're not going to put anything else there, just cat. And there we go. We've got a cat sitting. Let's have a look at the other options. That was a little strange, but... All right, now watch what happens if I change the shape of this. Now I'm going to go wide with this, and maybe I'll even go down more here. And we're going to go very wide. Now, I bet you we're going to get a cat that's lying down now. Notice, it's the shape. Now, I could type cat lying, but I'm just going to just click cat. And there we go. We've got a cat lying down. We've got three options. There's a second one. There's a third one. So I hope you noticed there that the shape of the selection was even more important than the descriptive words. Now, I can use other words, and generally speaking, I would, but I wanted to just really minimize the words to show you the power of the shape of that selection. So I hope you found this tip useful. Let me know in the comments underneath if you did. And by the way, check out my full video on Generative Fill in Photoshop. It's right up there. And if you're new, welcome to the cafe. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any of my videos. Until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.